It's time to rise and shine and get your morning started with Alabama's award-winning morning show.
6 o'clock already, I was just in the middle of a dream.
Get up, we gotta go to work.
What?
But I can't be late, cause then I guess I just won't get paid.
Why do people work?
Do any of you people do any actual work?
These are the days when you wish your bed was already made.
Broadcasting live from high atop Alabama's beautiful sand mountain.
I don't like Mondays.
Tell me why.
I don't like Mondays.
Tell me why.
No, you don't understand how radio works.
Monday, Monday. So good to me.
Doesn't hardly seem like work, does it?
It sure is Monday, hitting it now.
Except for Monday.
Let's get to work.
Please welcome your hosts.
Just another man.
Good morning, it's 6:10. It is a messy Monday morning, and did that shock you?
Swam to work this morning.
Yeah, the headphones here are a little messed up.
So our speakers got struck by lightning.
Yeah.
And we can't hear.
The headphones were really weird.
It's really weird, y'all.
It should sound fine on the radio, but here in this room, it sounds like we're in a...
Tunnel? Yeah, maybe like a flat tunnel.
Yeah.
It sounds like we're down in a deep, dark cave.
It does.
Because listen... It's silent.
It is.
And usually we have a little bit of feedback.
Something.
A little bit of something.
Something going on. Yeah. But it's that way. We've alerted the engineer.
We have.
Hopefully by lunch we'll get something going. But be careful driving. There's a lot of water standing on the roads. There's still a flash flood warning in effect for Marshall because it poured down between 1 inch and 2 inches of rain fell in an hour's time.
My goodness. Lots of tree limbs down, too. So you guys be careful. If you're on your way to work, take it a little bit slower. Maybe take it a little bit so you can see what's on the road ahead of you.
Yeah, because at least finally the sun is coming up, so that'll help you some. But there's a lot of tree limbs on the secondary roads. I know ARAB, they had a tornado warning we had three warnings at one time this morning when I came in early, and luckily, as far as we know, nothing touched down, but there's still damage from the straight line winds. Some of the winds were 60 miles an hour.
Wow.
And there's a lot of trees down in ARAB.
Mm-hmm.
They're showing trees down in Jackson County, parts of DeKalb County, Madison County. Luckily, no reports of any tornadoes touching down, but still there's damage from the tree from the straight line winds, and there's a few people without power.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was driving through downtown Albertville getting my coffee this morning, and the power's completely out. It's restored.
Now, they're working on it. There's
a
lot of people, especially in ARAB and the Gunnersville area, without power. They're working on it quickly to get it back up. As far as the weather at the moment, it's getting better. The strongest part of the system coming through is in southern Blount County, heavy rainfall, some lightning, and some strong winds. The very southern part of Etowah County. Then you've got St. Clair. Right now, Calhoun County is probably getting the worst of it as far as heavy rainfall, strong winds, some thunder and lightning, and some small hail in Calhoun County.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Ooh.
But once this gets out of here, probably in the next couple of hours, the rest of the week looks great. So if you're Memorial Day, if you're going to be outside looking for things to do, weather gets a whole lot better this afternoon. You're looking at sunshine, windy, highs in the mid-80s. Then there's no chance of rain till maybe late in the day on Friday, and that's only a 20% chance.
That's weird, because I was literally up to my ankles in water on the way here. So you're going to tell me it's sunny later?
It's going to be sunny later today.
All right.
And by middle part of the week, how about sunshine and about 80? So not as hot as it has been the past. Weekend was hot.
It was too hot
for
this early. I'm not ready. My parents' pool's not ready, so I'm not ready.
Well, that's why we're seeing the storms, and it's been a horrible weekend for the U.S. I read this morning 18 people were killed with tornadoes across the U.S. Texas, Oklahoma, Kentucky, and I believe might have been Iowa was
goodness.
The fourth state. It's been one of the worst weeks and one of the worst years as far as tornado outbreaks. But luckily, Alabama has been spared again this year for the most part. We've had some damage, but nothing like what they've seen in the other states.
You said in the winter that it would be a tough spring.
Yeah, they were saying because of this El Nino coming out of the west, it was going to really give us. They didn't know where, but they said that there's going to be a major series of outbreaks as far as tornadoes across the U.S. And
another El Nino?
The one that came in the wintertime that brought us, that's the one that's causing all this problem.
El Nino Part 2?
I guess.
God, don't you remember that big one, big El Nino did all that damage?
Exactly.
I don't know that. I heard your strap your Velcro.
Come loose.
Yep.
Scott called this morning, which I'm glad he did. Glad he did. I told him to anytime there's severe weather.
For sure.
And I was about to jump in the shower. He says, you got to hurry. I said, hurry is no longer in my vocabulary. I said, until my arm feels much better, I'm going to cannot hurry. Mm-hmm. But I tried to hurry, and yes, my shoulder's hurting this morning.
So how was this weekend? How was this weekend? How was feeling?
It was tough. I mean, you just cannot sleep. There's no way to get comfortable.
Can't get comfortable.
I'm not a back sleeper. I'm always on one side or the other. Always have been. And now with this, you almost have to sleep on your back.
Well, you do right now.
Yeah.
I think in the next couple of weeks.
It gets better.
I think as the weeks go on, you'll be able to turn over to that
when
other
the
side.
Brace comes off with the braces on here for another at least 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And so it was impossible. I've had very little sleep. And I've rested by not moving, but not resting as far as sleeping.
Oh, Lord.
But I'm not used to sleeping anyway, but
this is
at least I do sleep some.
Well, it's bad when you say you didn't get any sleep because you already don't sleep.
Yeah.
So you got double sleep.
Yeah. And then this is an adventure, putting clothes on and off and learning what parts of the body you can no longer wash effectively. Like with my left arm, I can't wash my right side.
Uh-huh.
Now, some of it you can do with your right arm, like you can wash your right leg and your
and
shoulder.
You don't have anybody to help.
No, and you can't wash your right armpit.
You can't wash your other armpit either.
Nope, because like a barrel, I'm not supposed to get it wet.
You're not supposed to wet.
That's where they reattach the bicep, is right under my armpit.
But he don't stink, y'all.
Good.
He don't stink.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Well, good.
I don't know if you're using deodorant or not, but you don't stink.
Yeah, I think it's the water pressure. It's just knocking the Kyarn off.
You had a bath this
morning.
It was Kyarn.
That's what my grandmother always said. You smell like Kyarn.
What is Kyarn?
We need to ask the listeners if they...
All right.
Because I always heard, look at a Kyarn. I'm guessing you spell it K-A, how would you say, I-R-N or K-A-R-N? Kyarn?
How do you spell Kyarn?
I don't know. Look it up.
Hey, Siri. Hey, Siri. How do you say Kyarn? I just said that, but I think she'll spell it.
Sure.
Okay. Hey, Siri.
How do you?
Spell Kyarn.
Sure. Translate into which language?
It won't even let me...
English.
English.
Does she even know what it is?
Nope. No.
Okay, so much for her.
All right, I'm just going to put it out there.
Type in K-A. We'll look it up. We'll figure it out.
Tell me how to spell it.
I would say K-A-I-R-N. I don't know. Somebody's calling out how to spell it.
All right, answer it.
I mean, no, I can't live on the air. You don't know what's going to happen.
True, you don't know.
Here we go.
Are you Googling it?
No, that's not this. Is the name for boys that comes from the masculine moniker? No, that's not it.
No.
Kyarn, maybe it's with the C. I don't know. Human pile of stones. No, that's not it. I don't know. We'll have to look into this one.
I put the question out there. Hey, we got a new listener of the day, and we got something else coming.
We do.
We got something coming that is so special this week. We are giving away a T-shirt every day this week.
Yes, we are.
We are.
Kind of a kickoff to unofficial kickoff of summer.
Yeah.
Giving a Barry and Holli Morning Show T-shirt.
Yes, because I'm not going to tell you where today, because Barry will tell you later. But we have tickets to go somewhere out of state that we're going to be giving away to listener of the week. And we're going to be doing that by commenting on the podcast post. Yeah. It's really easy.
Yeah. So just keep listening. We'll give you some more details on that coming up in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Go back to what we were talking about earlier. We just mentioned the word Kyarn.
Kyarn.
I mentioned it because I remember my grandmother, even my mother had said it years ago, that smells like Kyarn. I never knew what she was talking about. I just thought that was something that really stinks.
Yeah, but what did you say about the rain?
The rain.
You said it knocked the Kyarn.
About a shower. I said I can't wash my right side. I just let the water knock the Kyarn off.
There you go.
From my grandmother, what she said. But we some listeners have messaged us, and you found the actual meaning and the spelling of it on the internet.
I wish I hadn't.
So it's spelled two ways. One is K-Y-A-R-N, yeah. Then there's a C-Y-A-R-N.
Uh-huh.
And both of them roughly means the smell of a dead rotting flesh.
Basically, ooh. Yeah. Ooh. Good morning. How's your biscuit?
Yeah. So that's Kyarn. If somebody says you smell like Kyarn, you stink.
Yeah, so you don't want to be called Kyarn.
No.
I think the most southern saying would be bless your heart, though. Don't you think?
Yeah.
That's the most southern saying. Because my friends up north, they don't get that. I'll just say that like, bless her heart.
They don't know what that means.
Uh-uh.
It's a southern thing.
They don't get it that, they don't get the sarcasm in it. When they tell me a story and I'm like, bless her heart. They're like, what?
Well, hit them now with your breath smells like Kyarn. Hit them with that one and see what they say. They won't know, oh, well, thank you.
Yeah, hit them with
Kyarn. Thank you very much. Well, thank you so much.
Yes, dead flesh.
Yeah. But we're looking, if you have any other terms like that, feel free to go to our Facebook page and let us know.
Yeah.
And one thing on Facebook page, we put this post up, what day was it last week about Morgan Wallen?
Oh, my goodness. It was 6 days ago.
So it's almost a week from tomorrow. And it was a post of where a fan held up a sign at one of his concerts and said that she wanted him to draw her a tattoo.
Yeah.
And then she would then take whatever he drew and have it tattooed to her body. And he did that. He grabbed the sign, drew a little, what did he draw? Like it's...
It says
simply, well, he didn't really draw. It says, love ya, so does God. Then it's got an M and a W, kind of like in shape of a cat.
It looks like a kitty cat with whiskers.
So she took that and got a tattoo. Then she posted this. Her post has over 7 million views.
Oh,
and the post we put up on that story, tell them about how big this thing is.
So it has a Facebook reach of 227,000, and then we have 2,000 likes on the post. It's a really popular post, and all it is this girl, she went to the concert, she took a poster board, just a regular size poster board, and she said, Morgan, can you draw my first tattoo? And she drew out a little blank box, and then he grabbed the sign from her, wrote, love ya, so does God, wrote an M and then a W under the M with some squiggly lines, and it looks like a kitty cat.
Wow. So this thing is, I guess, our post is also going viral.
Yeah, so ours did. It says that her post has over 7 million views. I bet it has double that now.
Yeah.
Because this was a week ago. And our post has got 2,000 likes, so there's no telling what hers has got.
Yeah, so the insights, if you're familiar with this, insights, it's amazing. 228,000 impressions. So
that means we have reached 228,000 people's feeds.
With this one post.
Yeah.
Just and it's a good post. It's something good he did.
Yeah, it is.
And there were some people arguing about it on Facebook, as they always
they
will.
They did. Yes, I had to delete some comments. Y'all get spicy in the comment section sometimes. I have to tone you down.
Yeah.
Now.
What you should do is repost this. People who didn't see it the first time around, if you're just scrolling through Facebook this morning, we'll repost this again on top of our Facebook. It's a cool story.
Okay.
He stopped the concert and wrote this little note to her and drew something, and then she took it and did what she promised. She had a tattoo off of it. It's pretty good.
You did it because she's cute?
No, I think he just saw the sign, it got his attention, and he thought, I'm going to do something good. Because
I like it.
I think all the bad publicity he's had over the past few months, throwing the chair, things like that, I think he's going to be doing a lot of things like this to get back on people's good side.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Because that was what some of the comments were saying was more...
And I think that's a good move, too.
Yeah. He's got to rebuild himself.
Sure does. Sure does. So we'll repost that in a few minutes on our Facebook page.
Okay.
So check it out. 6:34.
Mornings with Barry and Holli here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Things going on. I'm excited. Tomorrow night, America's Got Talent.
Oh, it comes on. Back. Yay.
That's like still my favorite show because it's a show. For the most part, 99% of it you can watch with the entire family.
Yeah.
Occasionally, they'll get maybe a comedian who's maybe a joke or two, but for the most part,
not really.
It's really good.
Yeah.
And I love because you can take, or like Cody Lee, for example, a young man that if they didn't have this show, his talent would have never been realized and he wouldn't have went on to do the thing. He's autistic, blind, but he's an amazing singer, piano player, and now he has a headlining show in Vegas.
So you said, because we were talking about America's Got Talent, and it didn't hit me, but you said last year they did like a summer special.
They had the regular show. Then they had another show, was like the best of the best who came in from other countries and competed to be like the best of the best of America's Got Talent.
Who won? Do you remember?
I don't remember.
I don't remember who won. It, it was
remember.
Between the dog.
It might have been
the dog.
If it didn't happen last week, I don't know.
But, you've been on anesthesia.
But this one that starts tomorrow night is the normal one. Yeah, they've got Sophia. She's back.
Good.
Heidi, Howie Mandel, Simon Cowell. And Terry Crews is the host. So season 19 premieres tomorrow night at 7. And it's going to run through August. So it gives you a good summer show, good summer family show.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
So, yeah, I can't wait to see it tomorrow night.
Yeah. Does it come on once a week?
Once a week. Yeah, Tuesdays.
Good. Yep.
So tomorrow night. We'll give you more entertainment news coming up. Garfield and the new Furiosa movie, the new Mad Max movie, battling it out big time. The cat against Mad Max of sorts. And we'll tell you who won coming up in a few minutes.
Barry and Holly on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
Even though it's a holiday, the show must go on. Time for Holly's pile of stories. Big battle over the weekend. Furiosa, the new Mad Max movie, up against the Garfield movie. Who won the battle?
It was a close one. So Furiosa came in with $31 million and Garfield $30 million.
Wow.
Furiosa took it.
Cat fight.
It was a cat fight, yeah. And then the movie If came in at number 3 at $13 million. I've still yet to see that.
You know, there's some good family movies this summer.
They're really,
you've got Garfield, If, and then Despicable Me.
In and Out.
In and Out's coming out. And then I think there's another one. So there's like 4 or 5 good family movies this summer.
Yep.
Yep.
And following the success of Cocaine Bear, another furry four-legged creature is getting the comedy horror treatment. The werewolf.
What?
Yes. Yes.
Cocaine?
Cocaine werewolf.
How about new?
Yes.
Why?
Cocaine werewolf should be in theaters later this year. Did you see Cocaine Bear?
I saw part of it. I couldn't take it. That's exactly. I just wanted to see what all the talk was about.
I kind of do, too. I just want
to
see.
To me, it was one of the stupidest movies I've seen, but it did really well at the box office. That's why we have Cocaine Werewolf.
Why did it do good at the box office? Like, why don't people care?
It's like one of those like cheaply made, goofy movies that it was just so bizarre, people went to see it.
Okay.
So what's next? Cocaine cicadas? That will be the next one. You watch. You watch.
That's a good one.
Cocaine cicadas.
That's a good one.
That'll be the next one.
Well, Five Nights at Freddy's was the biggest horror film of 2023. And now we all know the sequel will land in theaters. It's been announced that the Five Nights at Freddy's 2 will open in theaters on December 5th. 2025.
Did you see Five Nights at Freddy's?
No,
I saw it, and to me, I was disappointed because then I had to stop and think that it wasn't made for me. It was made for a younger audience.
Yeah.
For the younger audience, it was kind of scary.
Yeah.
But for me, when you're looking at Scream and all these other ones, not scary at all, but it wasn't made for me. It was made for the much younger audience, and they loved it.
I have a 6-year-old and a 9-year-old, and they are fascinated, but I'm
terrified.
It
would scare them.
Yeah, it's terrifying. Yeah. It looks so scary.
And it's based off the game?
Yeah. There's like a video game.
It would scare them.
It looks brutal to me.
It did its job in scaring that age group.
Yeah. Why would you do that? Why would you want to target a horror?
Now they're having nightmares.
Yeah, 10-year-olds. I mean, my Lord.
I don't know.
Come on, guys.
Yeah. 6:56. Hey, we got a brand new song, our future hit, the new one from Darius Rucker and Jennifer Nettles. Now, you're a big fan of Darius,
Hootie
and the Blowfish.
Oh, yeah.
It's Darius and Jennifer Nettles called Never Been Over, our future hit. It's coming up next.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holly.
Congratulate our listener of the day, and it is Rita Lynn Smith.
Yes, Miss Rita Lynn Smith is going to get a t-shirt because we this is the first time we've ever done this. Usually, the winner of the listener of the week gets the t-shirt,
right.
So that's all 5 days. But all 5 days, Monday through Friday of this week, we're going to be giving away a t-shirt every single day.
Yes, we are.
The listener of the week.
And how do you get one? You simply listen to our podcast.
Just listen to our podcast and wait for our podcast post on Facebook and just comment, and there you go.
And you'll be qualified. We'll have another listener each day. Each of you will win a listener of the day QSB Morning Show t-shirt.
That's right. Now, next week,
it's even bigger.
It gets even bigger because
we'll have listener of the day t-shirts, morning show, and you could win tickets to Chattanooga.
Yes. And I think we should call it a little day trip.
Okay.
I love these little day
it
trips.
It is, because we're going to have tickets to the Tennessee Aquarium, to the IMAX Theater, and to the Discovery Museum.
Yes.
All in that one little area where the aquarium is. So you can spend the day there and
that's
have a good time.
So much fun.
So that's coming up next week.
Yes.
So we'll be giving you more details on how you can win that. Other things going on. Oh, our pet of the week.
Jasper.
Jasper the horse. Looking at Jasper's picture. This may be the funniest pet of the week photo we've had.
You got to see Jasper's picture. He's on our Facebook page. Yeah. Jasper the horse. He's got his mouth wide open. Tongue just a flopping. He is so cute.
And the owner, Tracy Perry, congratulations. You and Jasper won a $20 gift card from Food City of Albertville and Gadsden and a pet of the week t-shirt from Dixie Designs in Boaz, and we're going to donate $20 Food City gift card to Second Chance Shelter in Boaz. You want to see Jasper's picture, it's on her Facebook page, and it'll be on her big billboard on Highway 431 in Albertville later this morning.
Good.
All right, time for the words of wisdom quote of the day. Today, we're going for more of a funny one. I love Golden Girls, and you may be thinking, what quote did they have that was good? Well, they had tons of them.
So many.
So which one are you going with?
So Rose said this, who was Betty White in Golden Girls. She said, my mother always used to say, the older you get, the better you get, unless you're a banana.
That is true.
Yeah.
Unless you're a banana.
Unless you're a banana.
That's good.
Bananas don't age well.
I like it. Nope. 716.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Get in my belly. Come on.
A couple of food stories. Reese cups. I love Reese's cups. What about you?
Yes.
They have another big one. This one is the jumbo cup.
I thought they already had a big one.
This is bigger than the other one. It's bigger than the big one.
Okay. Yeah.
They have the big cup. Now they have the jumbo cup.
Ah.
So this they've been spotted, I believe, Walgreens, I've read, CVS, and Walmart. Now, these arriving in stores now. It's four times the size of a standard Reese's cup and double the size of a big cup.
Whoa. Four times.
So if you like the big cup, that's the one you're talking about.
Yeah.
It's now the jumbo cup in stores right now.
Yeah. And the slogan says, too big? Never.
Nope.
Oh my gosh. So one jumbo cup equals four Reese cups.
It does.
Stacked.
So if you're watching your weight, you might want to stay away from this
one. Stay away from the jumbo ones. Well, yeah. Well, I've got a neat one. Welch's new canned cocktails, which is, this is different.
What flavor?
They're inspired by real fruit flavors.
Okay.
The new ready-to-drink cocktails, which is a blend of vodka and real juice, will launch with four flavors. There's vodka transfusion, which sounds dangerous, vodka cranberry.
That's weird.
I know. Watermelon mule. And passion fruit mojito.
Okay.
Each of them have about 5.9% alcohol volume.
What's it called, and transfusion, you think?
I don't know. It says that it has the Concord grape juice along with citrus and ginger.
Ooh, I don't know about ginger.
And then the vodka cranberry has just the taste of cranberry juice and vodka. The watermelon mule has the taste of real watermelon juice and ginger.
What's up with the ginger?
I don't know.
Yeah.
And passion fruit mojito, that's going to have mint and lime.
And I don't want mint in my drink.
So if you had to pick one, which one are you going for?
I don't know. I don't want ginger. One? I guess cranberry, because it's the only one with just cranberry and no ginger.
I don't know.
What about you?
I guess I'd go for the cranberry, but I'd want to try a sip of the transfusion.
It's a weird name. It's a weird name.
Yeah, this should have been like a grape cocktail.
Explosion.
Grape explosion.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Read more about these on our Facebook page. Check them out at 729.
Barry and Holly. On Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Good morning. Memorial Day morning. A lot of people off work today, just now rolling around. Check out our Facebook page. All kinds of stuff going on. And like Holly mentioned earlier, in case you missed this, tomorrow when we have a listener of the day, you're going to win a morning show t-shirt.
That's right. Listener of the day is a little bit more special this week, because every day this week, the listener of the day will be getting a t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a Barry and Holly t-shirt. They are navy blue.
Yep.
They have the small pocket WQSB logo on the front and the big Barry and Holly logo on the back. And they are amazing.
Doesn't mean you qualify to win one. You will actually win one if you're the listener of the day tomorrow.
Yes, that's the difference. So usually it's a qualify to win on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
But this week, you automatically automatically win every day. So don't want to confuse you, but we're just throwing out extra gifts this week.
There you go.
And then next week, we are going to have tickets to the aquarium, to the Discovery Center, and to IMAX.
Yeah. So your chance to have a little day trip or day, or I guess day trip, it'll take you all day to go through the aquarium and watch a movie and go to the Discovery Museum. So be listening. More ways to win coming up, all kinds of stuff. And starting, I believe, Friday. Yes, it is Friday. We'll start Wolfstock 2024.
Oh, I'm excited for Wolfstock.
And I'm looking in the room across the hall from us. It's our t-shirt room, basically.
It is overflowing with tie-dye t-shirts.
We have beautiful t-shirts, Wolfstock t-shirts. We'll let Holli take a picture of one and show you what t-shirts you'll get this year when you deliver dog food by the station. Now, don't do it today. It'll start Friday. And coming up very soon, details on her Father's Day contest. And they can win a brand new riding lawnmower.
Yes, isn't that exciting?
Yep, so many things going on. This is going on. It's been a crazy year for things up in the sky. You know, we had the big eclipse back a couple of months ago.
Yeah.
Now, this is not as rare. We had one happen back in, I think it was earlier this year. Another one will happen later. But six planets will be lined up in a row. They're calling it a planet parade. You'll see six planets all lined up. So if you can go outside and you have a telescope, you can see four of these with a naked eye. Two, you'll need a telescope. You get Jupiter, Mercury, Uranus, Mars, Neptune, and Saturn. They're all going to be aligned in a row, and it's going to happen coming up on June 3rd.
I like this music that you're playing.
Yes. It just puts you in the mood to go outside and look. Now, this happens more often than you would think. Now, it's the way that the planets all move at a different speed, and occasionally, once or twice, maybe a year, they will line up in a pattern, in a line, and you can walk outside and see them in a row. Now, four planets, Jupiter, Mercury, Mars, and Saturn, will be visible with the naked eye, but you'll need high-powered binoculars or some kind of telescope to see Uranus and Neptune. Is that one of those words?
Yep.
A trigger word?
Yep.
Uranus?
Yep.
Oh.
I'm 5 years old.
I know. If they were to find water on Uranus and they said it was moist, that would, you would just fall apart.
Oh, my God.
You'd have to fall apart, wouldn't you?
There's people gagging on their bacon, egg, and cheese biscuits right now.
Harry Uranus is moist. Yeah, see, that's what you would be. See, you're falling apart now. We've just lost Holli.
I'm out.
Yeah, but it's the way to see this is, of course, you go out at night, look in the eastern sky. The planetary alignment will be visible almost everywhere in the northern hemisphere, weather permitting, and happens June the 3rd. So if you want to see this, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that is neat. I hope the weather permits.
I hope so.
Yeah.
So we'll make a note. June 3rd is when it happens.
Look for Uranus.
Yeah, look for Uranus.
Got it.
Yeah, so it's 7:42.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holli.
I'm so jealous. I've posted on our Facebook, what's your plans for Memorial Day? And we're sitting here behind the mics, which I love. Love being at work on Memorial Day. But there's people at the pool and at the beach.
Yep.
Jennifer McSpadden is at the beach. She sent us a balcony view.
Shame on you, Jennifer.
Shame on you, Jennifer, but I hope you enjoy it.
I do, too.
Melissa had a cookout yesterday, but today she's binging the new season of Young Sheldon. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, binge the TV.
Yeah.
Maria says, Spanish Fort, visiting my nephew's gravesite who has gone too soon.
Wow.
Remember what this day is truly about, those who served who we no longer have. That's
absolutely
so important.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yes.
Some other comments. Emily says she's working till 4. Pam Harris, go to Massange for a cookout. Felix Hamilton heading to Florida, Navarre Beach. Beautiful there.
Yes.
Audrey Hilburn doing some kayaking. Well, Audrey, you're probably going to have more water than usual.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the creeks and the waters around the area are higher than usual.
Yeah.
That's why there's still a flash flood warning for parts of Marshall and DeKalb County this morning.
Yeah,
be careful. Catherine Elliott working on the ambulance. Thank you for what you do, Catherine. Amanda Lewis hanging around the house. Maybe a nap later since I didn't sleep well with the weather earlier.
That's me.
Yeah.
Amanda, I was up at 3 o'clock and so was Barry. We talked about you got up at 3 because you had to come in and do the weather.
Yeah.
And then I got up at 3 because of the weather and tried to drift back and forth. But, I mean, I had to.
It's hard.
Yeah,
it's a lot of lightning this morning.
It was so loud.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that'll be fun. Kendra Helms is working. Emily is working. Connie's working. Leslie's working. Kayla's working. Yep. Nathan Lambert is listening to the morning show and doing a cookout. So this is where the podcast is perfect for you guys, is we can recap everything and you can have the morning show whenever you want it at your fingertips.
There you go. And if you're looking for stuff to do today, I saw this. Let me ask you.
Yeah.
A recent survey. They surveyed 2,000 Americans who went to a movie, and as they were coming up, they said, okay, how long is the perfect length of time for a movie?
Mm-hmm.
How long? Because some movies are like Titanic, for instance.
My favorite.
3 hours and what?
15 minutes, yeah.
That was a bathroom break movie for me.
Oh, you...
I try my best not to, because I don't want to miss anything, but I could not hold it.
Well, when it came out on VHS, it came out in two sets. So, like, it had an A and a B. So you had to separate it. So I always took my bathroom break when I had to change out the VCR.
Gotcha.
You know?
Yeah.
That's how long it's been my favorite movie for probably 20 years.
So do you think 92 minutes is the perfect length for
a
movie?
I think that is 90 minutes is the perfect length.
I agree. That's 92 minutes. And they ask them, okay, what is the perfect 92-minute movie? And they give them a list of them. And they voted for Dodgeball, Kung Fu Panda, Beetlejuice, Monsters, Inc., and Toy Story 2.
Love Beetlejuice. Love Monsters, Inc. Mm-hmm. I would watch Tombstone.
Tombstone.
Yeah.
I bet it's a little longer than 2 hours. But, yeah, that's a good movie, though. Ask Siri.
Hey, Siri.
Yeah.
How long is the movie Tombstone?
I'm saying 2 hours and 15 minutes.
The runtime of Tombstone is 2 hours and 10 minutes.
Close. Oh, you were close.
I remember.
Yeah. That's one of my favorite. That's also another one.
That's
a
good
favorite.
One. Yeah. To me, if I want to watch this day perfect movie, what is the perfect movie just to sit and watch? You said Tombstone or mm-hmm. Titanic.
Yeah.
I love Caddyshack.
Oh, okay.
It's an older movie. Yeah. It's just a good movie with Bill Murray and Chevy Chase. Rodney Dangerfield, the cast is amazing. And it's just good for a laugh.
And you love Spider-Man.
I'd like to see the latest Spider-Man movie. I think it was one of the best ever. So, yeah, probably one of those.
Did you see it in theaters?
Yes.
And
so
it hadn't come out on a
You can watch it on pay-per-view, but it's never been on a streaming platform unless you pay for it. I don't understand why.
How long ago?
It's been a couple of years, 2 to 3 years.
Well, that's weird.
It is weird.
Huh.
That you have to pay to watch it, even today.
So, there's nowhere that streams it free?
I can't find it.
Mm.
Google. We'll have to watch it.
Yeah.
All right, 7:56.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Looks like a good week, too. We'll tell you all about the weather coming up in a few minutes. And if you're looking for a new lawnmower, we've got you one coming your way very soon.
We do.
Yeah, our Father Mo's Best Contest, Bonds Appliance, Lawn and Garden in Gunnersville, teaming up with us and giving away a brand new, beautiful riding lawnmower for Dad for Father's Day.
Yes, and this is over a $3,000 value.
Yes, it is.
Lawnmower.
And we're just, a couple of weeks away from Father's Day?
Yeah, just a couple weeks.
Yeah, I'm coming up in the next few days. We'll tell you more details, but you can just go to your website and upload a photo of Dad with his lawnmower, if Dad doesn't have one, in case his lawnmower is so bad, you can go stand next to the neighbors.
Yeah.
Say, hey, can I get a picture next to your lawnmower?
Yeah. So is the video we shot, is that for the lawnmower?
Nope, that's for the next thing.
Because,
you know, June is going to be a very big month here at QSB with stuff that you can win. Because, like you mentioned, we're giving away morning show T-shirts every morning this week, even though we're still in May. Every morning this week with our listener of the day. So you listen to our podcast, which will be coming up around 10 o'clock this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Then you comment on it on our Facebook page. And then tomorrow morning we'll randomly select one person and you win a morning show T-shirt. We're doing that all this week. And then next week we're going to do the same thing, but we're also giving away free tickets to Chattanooga.
Yes, doing a whole family experience. It's going to be amazing.
To the Tennessee Aquarium, to the IMAX Theater, and the Discovery Museum.
Yep.
So that's next week. We're giving away tickets for that. We'll be giving away tickets to Chattanooga off and on over the month of June. And then we have the Father's Day promotion. And then coming up later in June, the middle part, giving away a brand new grill with our Grills Gone Wild contest.
We can't say that with a straight face. Grills Gone Wild.
And I can't wait for you to hear the promo we're going to cut, because you're going to be doing some singing.
Yes, I'm going to sing for this promo.
You're going to sing the Motley Crue song, Girls, 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 but we're changing it to Grills, Grills, Grills. And then people will get to send us a picture of Dad next to a grill. But here's the catch. We need Dad dressed as, or doesn't have to be dad, even if you're not a dad, if it's the
mom.
Mom,
yeah.
Anybody.
Mama.
Could be dressed as Cousin Eddie in National Lampoon's Vacation. It's the famous grilling scene from the very first Vacation movie where Clark and the family, the Griswolds, are at Eddie's house. And he's over there grilling. He's grilling the hamburger helper. And we, the staff here, we shot a video takeoff on that famous movie scene.
We did. And I have edited it, and it is finished, and it is funny.
It's funny.
Yeah.
So we're going to put that on their website and Facebook in the next few days, and then we'll let you start sending us your pictures soon, probably towards the middle part of June.
Yeah.
And you can win a brand new grill.
Harlow called me cringe.
Cringe?
Yeah, she said just my part.
Oh.
She was like, oh, mama, that's cringe. And I was like, why?
Is that bad?
Well,
cringe is bad?
Yeah, cringe means like... like that.
I thought you showed it to her?
Yeah.
I thought you nailed it.
I thought it did okay.
Cringe.
Yeah, everything that I've done lately. I posted a picture of me and her on my Facebook stories, and I put, hanging with my bestie, and she said, that's so cringe.
Cringe.
Yeah, she was like, don't put that on there. That's cringe.
Hit her with one and say, well, you smell like Kyarn. See what she says about that.
Yeah, but then she'll ask me what it is, and I don't know.
Rotting flesh.
Ew. But that's not what Mama used to call it. Like, when she would say, you smell like Kyarn, she's not saying you smell like dead flesh.
No, she just meant it really stinks.
Yeah, it just really stinks.
Yeah.
Who knows?
So anyway, there's a lot of stuff coming up, so just keep listening.
Yeah, June is like absolutely bursting at the seams with giveaways.
So a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the key things is you need to check out our podcast every day and listen to the morning show.
And we're going to be burying some Easter eggs in those podcasts, so you do want to listen.
So if you're just not getting up since it's a holiday, you missed the first 2 hours of the show, you can catch the entire show coming up roughly around 10 o'clock. The podcast will be available. It'll be wherever you find your podcast.
Yeah, and let us know where we're hanging out with you. If we're by the grill or if we're at the beach or wherever we are.
By the lake, wherever you're in.
Yeah, wherever we are, we want to know.
Yep, let us know. All right, it's 8:16.
Barry and Holly on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
So the weather does look good today, but a lot of people, I noticed on our Facebook page, messaging, you're asking, what are you going to be doing today? Some said, catching up on my sleep because the storms woke me up this morning.
I know, and that's definitely what I'm going to be doing today.
Here's Holly earlier. She nodded off. So, and I'm with you. I'm a little tired this morning. I haven't slept any because of my shoulder surgery.
Yeah.
And I'm not a back sleeper. I'm a side sleeper. And it's impossible to sleep on the side when you've got shoulder surgery. So, I need some sleep.
I'm with you. I've been up since 3. I know you get up at 3 every morning.
Yeah.
But I need a good 9-10 hours of sleep every night. I know that's a lot.
Well, there's a study. Let me ask. I'm glad you mentioned this.
Yeah.
Study found that adults worldwide, they surveyed 68,000 people and asked them, on average, how much sleep do you think you need each night? And the answer is 7 to 9 hours of sleep, somewhere in that area.
Okay.
So do you think you get that much?
No, I don't think that I get 9, but I think I'd try to shoot for 9.
Okay. That's what they said. They need 7 to 9. Only 15% said they actually get 7 to 9.
Mm-hmm.
During the week. They said one night, maybe, but 5 nights, no.
And I will tell you, those people that are sleeping so good do not have children. They do not.
Nope.
Mm-mm.
Nope. And they don't work the morning shift on the radio.
No, they don't. Or a health care shift.
Yeah, they say on average, most of us average, we hope to get 7 to 9. We average 6 to 7 on average.
I knew a doctor that slept about 30 minutes a night.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's all. About 30 minutes a night. How do you do that?
He's got to take naps somewhere along the way.
You have to.
Got to.
You would die.
Because Oprah used to say that she would sleep about 3 hours a night.
No.
That she would work in a nap or two during the day.
Oh, I love 2 naps.
Now, I don't think 14 hours is a nap, but that's what...
Who says?
No, I don't know. But these people who get 7 to 9, that's what people shoot for.
Mm-hmm. I will have to say, since starting this job, I take more naps.
Yeah.
Because I have to get up so early.
I get up
at 4.
Yeah.
So it's not... And I go to bed around 8. So, or earlier, because
it's hard for you on the weekend. You say because the girls, they don't. You want to nap, but you can't nap because you want to be with the girls. It's hard to do.
I can't. So, like, it's limited. My girls have to go with their dads every morning.
Yeah.
So I feel guilty if I nap when I have time with them, but that's also the only time that I have away from the job.
Gotcha.
So I don't know. I don't. It's parenthood. You don't know what you're doing.
It's hard.
It's hard.
But it's amazing that it's not just us. People worldwide or in the U.S. are getting less sleep than ever before.
How many hours a night would you say you get?
I try to go to bed sometime after 8. Uh-huh. Usually it takes me about 30 minutes. So roughly 8:30 to 3, but I don't sleep the full 8:30 to 3.
So you're getting like 5 hours.
Probably not even that much, because I'll sleep maybe an hour and wake up. Mm. Takes me a few minutes to go back to sleep. Sleep an hour, go pee. Go back to sleep. So from 8:30 to 3, that's roughly 3. That's 7, but I don't sleep the full 7 hours. Yeah. Not even close. I'd say 5 hours maximum.
You can't even toss and turn right now.
No, I can't even. I can toss, but then I've got to get up and go cry because I've just tossed and landed on my shoulder. And I'm not a back sleeper. I hate sleeping on the back.
God, I don't trust back sleepers. No. I think they're a weird crew of
you don't
people.
Trust, yeah.
I don't trust somebody that sleeps on their back.
I'm with you.
I sleep on my side.
Got to.
I know where my mental state's at.
Yeah.
You know,
I don't trust the stomach sleepers.
No.
How do you do that?
Oh no, that feels good.
Does it?
Ooh, on your back.
No, on your stomach.
No, yeah, I know.
Really? That feels good?
Yeah.
Okay.
It gets all the pressure off your back.
Gotcha. But you don't like the back sleeping?
No. No,
I don't either.
No. I can't sleep on my back.
Nope. Can't do it.
Nope.
Yeah. It's 8:30.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holly.
Animal story. Now, you have a dog.
I do.
Doug.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Doug, does he like to play?
No. He's old.
Okay. Well, there's a new study saying that dog play dates can help prevent them from getting canine dementia.
What?
I didn't know that was a thing. I didn't know.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
How do you know? Wait a minute.
I mean,
wait
canine
a minute.
Dementia.
How do you know? How do you know about canine dementia?
I don't. That's why I don't know. But I'm reading the story.
But I mean, like, how do you know if your dog has dementia?
I don't know.
Okay, go ahead with the story.
The study says that play dates for your dog, like exercising, socializing, learning and playing with other dogs, are important factors in preventing canine dementia. They say that social and cognitive enrichment can also shield dogs from brain cell death and brain restructure loss, which causes memory and cognitive issues.
Mm-hmm.
I guess that the dog doesn't seem to, or maybe changes the way he acts towards you, is how you know.
Okay, yeah, I could say that.
Like maybe he doesn't come to you when you call him.
Okay.
Maybe he's a little different around you. Like he doesn't seem to be the same dog around you as he gets older.
Yeah.
Possibly. I don't know.
That'd be awful.
That would.
Oh my gosh. I don't want that to happen to my dog.
But are dog play dates a thing?
Oh yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Oh yeah, for sure. Like it's not like, but it's like, hey, do you want to meet up at the park and mm-hmm. walk our dogs?
Yeah.
Like that's a play date. You let your dogs play and then you sit and gossip about people.
While your dogs are out
there
playing.
While your dogs play, yeah. You see?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just some gossip, you know, a little gossip sesh. Get it out. Get it all out. And then let the dogs play.
I'm with you. I think dogs need other dogs.
Doug play. Now, you asked me if Doug plays, and I said no. I thought you meant with toys. He doesn't play with toys, but he loves to play with other dogs.
Other dogs.
Yes. Now, he gets aggressive. He's a little
gotcha.
Aggressive. When he plays with the other ones, but he loves it. And it does, it keeps him young, it keeps him active. I think the doggy play dates are a great idea.
I didn't realize that was a new thing.
It was a thing. Yeah.
They recommend it.
Yeah.
It's good for many reasons.
Mm-hmm. Like different areas around town here, we have dog parks.
Sure.
And people walk their dogs down by the lake and they gather.
They may find that love of their life.
Oh, they may.
You don't know.
You won't know.
One minute you're talking to your friend, gossiping, look over and there, oh, okay.
No.
They like each other a lot.
They're locked up.
Okay. I was going to leave in about 5 minutes, but it'll take longer.
Got to wait for the
it'll be a little bit longer. A little bit longer. Yeah, it's 8:44.
Mornings with Barry and Holly. here on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
And always we'll leave you with the words of wisdom quote of the day. Some of these are inspirational. Some make you stop and think. Occasionally, sometimes, I think we just need a funny one.
Yeah.
And we have one today.
So this one is by Rose, who was played by Betty White in Golden Girls. And she says, "My mother always used to say, the older you get, the better you get. Unless you're a banana."
That is so true.
Yeah.
It's about the only use for an old banana is either feed a monkey or make banana pudding.
It's banana pudding every time.
Banana pudding.
Yes, yeah, sir.
That's a good one. All right, be sure and check out our podcast. It'll be up around 10 o'clock this morning. And by doing this and comment on it, you'll have a chance to win a QSB Morning Show t-shirt we'll give away tomorrow morning. So hope you have a great day. It's 8:52.
Barry and Holly. On Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.